Hey, what's up? It's another video from Daddy T from beautiful Yokosuka, Japan. Beautiful sunny day, August day. My birthday's coming up soon. August is the best month out here. Too bad we got COVID to deal with. Anyhow, this video is going to talk about how to pay almost any bill in Japan. Now, bills, what are we talking here? We're talking utility bills, we're talking credit card bills, if they're Japanese credit card bills, we're talking property tax bills. If you own a home, you can pay almost any bill at a 7-Eleven, at a Family Mart, or at a Lawson's. They do have smaller chains like Sunkus and a couple others, but the three big ones in Japan are 7-Eleven, Family Mart, and Lawson's. They all have great fried chicken, by the way. The only place there is not a 7-Eleven, where 7-Eleven does not exist, is in Okinawa. I lived there for 3 years back in 2008 to 2011. And my wife is actually from there, and when we go back, we still never see a 7-Eleven. So it's not in Okinawa, but 7-Eleven exists here. It is your friend. You probably already know you could pull money out of here in dimensions of 10,000 yen. So you can pull 10,000, 20,000, 30,000, 40,000. I've pulled up a max of about almost 70,000 yen. I think it was actually, 70,000 yen. Out at one time with my Navy Federal card, if you ever need to. I think they expanded the amount that you can take out because of COVID. It used to not be like that. You can only pull out like 40,000 or something. Now it's about 70,000 yen. So now I'm going to walk in here and I'm going to show you how to go ahead and pay this bill. Now, some of you are signed up with GI Bill Pay. If you're affiliated with a base, that's fine. They pay your bills for you. But if, you know, for some reason you have to pay the bill by yourself, what'll happen is the utility company will send you a slip. Now, not all slips that they send you are for payment. If they do not have a barcode on it, it is not for payment. It is just to show you how much your bill is going to be. But if you have a barcode on your slip, then you can take that to a convenience store and pay with cash. And you can pull money out via the ATM that is there. Now, Family Mart ATMs are usually not too friendly. They're getting a little bit better, but they're not too friendly with American cards. But 7-Eleven is friendly with Navy Federal cards. Also, you might not know this, but you can pull out money from a Japanese post office with your Navy Federal card or any Western card in the dimensions of 1,000 yen. So say you only have $70 in your account, but you want to go get some drinks. And as long as the post office is open, they usually close around 5 o'clock. They have various times that they close, but most of the time they close, the ATM portion of the post office closes at 5 o'clock. So as long as it's open, you can pull out 1,000, 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 yen. It's not like 7-Eleven where you have to pull out 10,000 yen. Now, 7-Eleven, you could pull out 10,000 yen. You could pull out 10 1,000 yen bills to equal 10,000 yen, but it has to be at least 10,000 yen, any charge, according to how much you pull out. So, let's go inside and pay a bill. Okay, take this bill for example. This bill is 58,649 yen. This is for a credit card, a Japanese credit card for my wife. I'm going to pay this at the register. You see here's a barcode right here. They're gonna scan it. I'm gonna hit the OK button. I'm gonna give them, 60,000 yen, and that should take care of it. Got some nice yummies there too.
scan it. Technical difficulties here. Let's scan it. Button should probably gonna come up. Genkin shiharai. Migi no? Okay. So yeah, press the right button. Instead of paying with cash. I'm gonna put the cash down. Hit the OK button. Usually, this always comes up. OK button. Shows you your change right here. That's it. Hey, arigato gozaimasu. Thank you. Oh. Then they're going to stamp it and they're going to give you a receipt. And they keep half of it and you take the other half. Word to the wise, keep your receipts because I've had instances where people have come back, utility companies have come back and said, I didn't pay a bill, but I showed them my receipt. And then you just walk right away. So keep your receipt, folks. This is a little bit different because this is for a credit card, but same rules apply. They stamp it, they rip it in half, and give you your share of this. Which you keep. Thank you very much.
All right, so we just successfully paid my wife's Japanese credit card bill for the month, so that should keep them away for another month, keep the wolves at bay. Little recap on what happened. So as you saw, there were two green buttons that came up on the LCD screen. That's unusual. That's just for when you're paying like a Japanese credit card or something like that, or property tax or something like that. But when it's a utility bill, water, gas, electric, stuff like that, you will only get the OK button. Just say it's OK. You hit the OK button after they scan it, and then you give them the cash, you get your receipt, and you just walk away. And as always, hold on to your receipts for at least a year, 2 years. I like to have a little file where I keep my receipts in. Then that's for anyone that's not affiliated with the base, even if you are affiliated with the base. I'm affiliated with the base, but I pay my own bills because I've been here so long. I've been here for 2 decades continuously, so I know how to pay bills on my own. So I don't use like a proxy or somebody to pay my own bills because it's my money. I want more control over it. So I'm not knocking other services that are out there. I'm just telling you, if you have the power and you have the knowledge, you can do it yourself, what you gained here today. So I hope this video helps. Like, subscribe, do what you gotta do. I'm gonna keep posting because I love Japan, love this weather, and you guys stay safe out there, okay? All right, goodbye.